How you guys doing? My name is Brandon Love. I'm a recent LMU graduate, graduated this past spring with my degree in business entrepreneurship. Just to give you guys a little bit more background, I grew up in Los Angeles, so I've been here my whole life. In a single parent household, just my mom and my two brothers, low income. So when I speak about the financial literacy program, it's not coming from a place of I know it all or I knew it all. It's coming from a place of these are the mistakes I made along the way, and this is how I see this program preventing someone like you from making the same mistakes. I work for myself as of now. I have a company called Soli Lace Sneakers, and what we do is we buy, sell, and trade high-end shoes like Jordans, Nikes, Adidas, things like that. I'm actually at my store in June right now, so those are all shoes back there. I think I was about 16, 17 years old when I got started. I had a couple pair of shoes, and I was like, I want to start making some money, so I sold those. But it didn't really take off until I turned 18. I remember getting a credit card. And what I did with that credit card was I bought shoes from Foot Locker, took it down to my Instagram or Facebook, I think, at the time, sold it on there, and then I kept the profits, and then I paid back my credit card company. Kept doing that for a while until I was able to use my own money to reinvest into my company. I say that to say that it's all a part of financial literacy. You have to be creative about some things. You have to find different ways. And I definitely think that the financial literacy program exposes different ways to be financially independent, to not have to. It might not be one way to make $1 million tomorrow, but it's definitely a way that'll keep you on a consistent track to achieve your goals that you want to achieve in life. Because you do need money. Money is just a tool, though. And what this financial literacy program does is it helps you use these tools to achieve what you want to achieve in life, which is ultimately the point of the tool. So I will say kudos to you guys for getting started early, because people don't even pay attention to these kind of things. I mean, it's not taught in school, so it's really not even our fault. But for you guys to go out and actually want to learn these things, you're going to be ahead of the game. So congrats again. You're getting started in a great program, and it's not because I had any part in it. Kind of is, but again, it's a great program, and you guys are doing well and amazing things. So stay up, man, and good luck.
Hey, Save It Forward, this is Brett Sifling, one of your past instructors. I'm actually the director of the Get Invested program here at Gerber Kawasaki. I started trading about a decade ago, and it's been a wild journey. Can remember when I was learning from peers and mentors like you guys are right now. My advice to you is get excited about investing. Don't go after the get-rich schemes. If it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. And what you should be doing is finding great companies with long growth potential over the long term, and stick with those. Invest in them, read about them, and just learn over time. And time is on your side. You guys are young, so you should be excited. So get connected, talk to your peers, talk to your mentors, reach out to professionals like myself. A lot of us are willing to help you. And remember to get invested. See you guys, and good luck.
Good day, everybody. Will DeHoo here, executive director and founder of the Foolproof Foundation. I'm here today to congratulate you on working through and passing the Save It Forward campaign or project. And I hope you learned a lot of meaningful life and financial skills that you can take with you and make the right financial decisions. I'm from Holland originally. Started the Foolproof Foundation about 10 years ago when I first came to America and noticed a big difference between American young people and European young people. I'm very much from a savings culture. If you want something, you work for it, save up some money, and you buy yourself the item that you want. Coming to America, I met a lot of young people that were trying to do the same thing that I was trying to do, like make the most of your life, you get your education, and try to find a good job, and so on, while you try to have some fun. And I met a lot of young people that were trying to do the same thing, but had credit cards to pay for things and were driving in big cars. And I was like, wow, that's the American dream that we see back home in movies and TV series and so on. And it is not until you get to know people better that you find out that that is not so easy, and it's not free money that you get in America, and that a lot of young people get in trouble with money, have their cars repossessed, hurt their credit, and getting credit card debt and so on. And noticed that about 10 years ago, and decided to help do something about that through the Foolproof Foundation and create meaningful financial education programs that are both fun but also have that right knowledge and tools, or include the right knowledge and tools to help the user make the right financial decisions, become a healthy skeptic when it comes to their spending and the way they handle their money. So I hope you learned something through the Foolproof program, and I hope you learned a lot through the Save It Forward project. All skills that you can take with you to be a smart consumer and make the right financial choices in life. So thank you for working through the program, and hopefully we'll see you another time on one of the Foolproof modules or programs. So thanks, and good luck out there.
Hi everyone, Darlene Fukuji here from the LMU Fred Huesner Center for Entrepreneurship. I wanted to congratulate you on completing the Save It Forward initiative powered by Foolproof financial literacy program. You guys all did an amazing job. I know that it's so hard to commit to finishing, especially in these crazy summer months in a pandemic, and I just want to say how proud I am of you for finishing. And I really enjoyed interacting with all of you, your communities, your mentors, your parents, and I am so excited for your futures as you have learned some of these great concepts about how to manage your money at such an early age, and hopefully you'll use it as a tool to empower you to achieve your long-term dreams and success. I wish you the best, and feel free to be involved with our program, give back, and continue to learn, and you will have access to the platform and can continue learning and your journey of growing. Thank you. Bye.